Aging Matters on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Area Agency on Aging.
Hello, and welcome to Aging Matters. This is a show that is provided by and sponsored by the Berks County Area Agency on Aging. My name is Ann Barlet. I'm the Public Advocacy and Outreach Manager for the agency. We have a wonderful guest lined up today and a great show. So without further ado, I'd like to welcome our guest for today is Dave Shallcross, and he is the Director of the Senior Protection Unit for the Pennsylvania Office of Attorney General. Welcome, Dave.
Thank you, Ann. It's great to be here on the show today. And it's a great pleasure to share all this great information with the residents here in Berks County.
Thank you. I know that there's a lot going on in your world, but unfortunately, the subject that we're going to talk about today is also going on even with this crisis. Criminals are hard at work, and they're not letting the coronavirus pandemic interfere with them at all, with their continuation to target individuals, and then including older adults, out of money and other things. And so because they continue to work hard, even during the coronavirus, there are some things that the scam artists or the criminals are doing specifically related to the coronavirus, and then other things that are occurring due to the situation with the coronavirus. So I thought we would talk about, I know you've got a great program to talk about some of the aspects and the areas that the scammers are using during this pandemic. So let's start right in. I know that one of the first things you wanted to talk about is a broad area that I think will really define better for people, and it's called supply scams. So why don't we begin with that, Dave, and tell us again or tell us a little bit first about how the Pennsylvania Office of Attorney General is working to fight again this now new criminal action first before we get into what specifically with the supply scam.
Absolutely. Yeah, thank you so much for breaching that the way you did, because Ann, you're right on target. Regardless to the issues and concerns that we all have in our neighborhoods and communities right now with the pandemic, criminals are not giving us a break. You know, they're going to ramp it up. Every opportunity that they have to take advantage, they're going to use. And an Office of Attorney General under our director, Josh Shapiro, our attorney general, he's very much aware of this, and we need to protect the citizens. So what we're doing is a multifaceted approach. A lot of different divisions within the office are engaged in this problem right now. We have our Consumer Protection Bureau, which is taking a lot of complaints and concerns about consumer issues. We have our healthcare section, Ann, and they take concerns regarding any healthcare related issue or topic, which could be your pharmacy, your doctor, medications, the sales of medical devices, personal protection equipment, those type of things. And of course, we have our nursing home complaints and concerns for those that are in those in communities and long-term living facilities. You know, we have a lot of problems there. That seems to be the nucleus of a lot of the deaths, unfortunately, and it's very sad that we have that problem. But we're getting a lot of concerns, and we've actually opened a number of investigations, which I really can't get into any ongoing investigations, any details. But I am assuring our citizens here in the state of Pennsylvania that the Attorney General is well aware, and we are taking action steps. We have our Medicaid fraud section, which investigates elder abuse and neglect of care, and of course, all your concerns, issues, and questions can come through our Senior Protection Unit. We'll get you within the right parts of the office. And, you know, some of the things might not be within our jurisdiction, as we always try to warn everyone. If not, we'll give you resources. We'll hook you up with Senior Law Center, CARI, the Area Agency on Aging, like yourself there, Ann. You know, you're a big help. And I want everyone in Berks County to understand that you're there to help them as well. So it's a great team effort.
Absolutely. Thank you. Appreciate that. Yes. We're all in it together, as they say. So let's start in, because the show, we really wanted to hone in on one area of all of that, which is the scams continuing to go on through this pandemic. So why don't you start us off with one of the first ones that you're aware of that is kind of out there in the community?
Well, this program is called the Novel Coronavirus Protect Yourself from Fraud and Scams, and it's our financial scams edition. You know, there's a lot of scams regarding cures and treatment and things, and I find that when we look at the results of these scams, that it's all about the money, right? So supply scams, I mean, that's something we're all hit with. I was just in the grocery store with my wife the other day. We take turns. One of us will stay in the car. The other goes in the store because we don't want to contribute to the number of people in the store. We don't want to contribute to that problem. So we're being very cautious ourselves when we do venture out. And we see the supply scams. You know, people are overbuying. They're stocking up. And there's no need for some of that. You know, buy what you need. Leave enough for others. Because some people are coming to the store and they're leaving empty-handed. And that's a tragedy. We can't have that. So we want you to deal with reputable vendors, stores that you know, stores that you trust. If it's online, again, the same kind of thing. And if you're going to be online, let's confirm the source. What's the web page? Type it in yourself. Links, shortcuts, and emails can mislead you and take you to dangerous sites and fraudulent offers. These fake websites, they won't offer the right items. It won't deliver the goods. It'll appear like you're getting what you need, but they may never appear at your doorstep. So that's another problem. We want you to compare prices, look out for those hidden fees, and be alert for counterfeit products. That hand sanitizer that's mostly water and aloe is not going to help you. And if you're paying premium cost, you're not getting the actual item that's going to be beneficial to you. You're wasting your money.
I know that, yeah, I think that there are a lot of us that couldn't go out. There's some seniors that are unable to go out or that we're encouraging not to go out during the pandemic. And so they're trying to order things online, or people who just respect the fact that it's may not be safe in that order. You think ordering online is actually safer, but certainly the products, you know, may not be the a good reputable manufacturer with that product that you're hoping to get, and then will you get it or won't you? So it will be effective. I think that the supply scam with both ordering and then also in person, but I see it as something that's affecting a lot of people because we were all trying to do ordering online. So, you know, they want to make sure that they've got, as you said, a reputable site and that the product is exactly what it is that they're looking for, like hand sanitizers, face masks, things like that, right?
Yes. And you know, again, I think you're giving good advice to folks. You know, if you're going to be online, just be extra cautious, because when you're physically in the store, you can handle the item, look at the item, read the fine print. When you're online, you don't always have that available. So first thing is, make sure it's a real site and that you're entering all the characters in the upper window on your website browser to go directly to the site, not using a shortcut or a link. Look at the items. If it sounds too good to be true, it probably is. Try to get brands that you recognize and know. And again, deal with vendors that you've dealt with in the past, even though you may not have gone online to your local supermarket or department store. Make sure that's where you're going and not to a site you've never heard of. So they're good tips, Ann.
Okay, good. Well, right on the heels of that, Dave, I think that the next thing that goes into my mind is, how do I know that what I'm ordering then, whether it's online or in the store, is actually a good price? Are they, you know, I see advertisements on TV for face masks, for example, or for a kit that you can get. You can get a face mask and a thermometer and, you know, gloves and items that either I might not need totally, or if I want a mask, somehow this mask is costing a lot of money. So I think then that's kind of a lead into maybe your second one, which is actually that price gouging scam, right?
Yes, yeah. Price gouging is a serious matter. And, you know, we're looking at price gouging is not just on the essential physical medical type devices, such as sanitizers, masks, and gloves. But we're also talking about groceries. We're talking about everyday items. It's clothing, food. It could be any of these things. So price gouging is not exclusive to the personal protection equipment. It's open to all these issues. So our tips, again, are very simple. Price shop before making that purchase. You know, kind of do some homework. Now, I'm not encouraging people to go store to store. Again, we want to reduce that exposure, but do your shopping by telephone if you have to. If you're not online, that's okay. Pick up the phone. Call 4 grocery stores that are close to you. Ask if it's in stock. Ask the brand, the size of the package. Are you paying 16 ounces the same price, or is one package 12 ounces? That's why it's a little less. So that way you'll have an idea of what you need, where it's at, and what it will cost before you venture out. Or online, same thing. Go to multiple sites and do a side-by-side comparison. Watch out for those items, though, that we talked about, the essentials. And when we talk about what is price gouging, and I think that's a good question, Ann, that you had here for me. You know, that price of the item that you're looking at currently cannot exceed 20% of the week prior's pricing right before that emergency declaration was made, the state of emergency. Once that's made, price gouging goes into a protective mode. So you don't have to be a mathematician. You know, I get people say to me, oh my gosh, I don't think I can remember what the price was 2 weeks ago, last week. 20%, I don't really know. Hey, if it sounds unreasonable, report it. We'll do the math. We'll investigate. Let us do our job at the Office of Attorney General. We don't expect you to know that every penny and what the pricing was. Was it a coupon? If it sounds unreasonable, we want to know about it. And again, review those receipts, make sure it's the price that you're paying. And, you know, bait and switch schemes are a big problem right now as well.
So Dave, the first thought that came into mind was the egg crisis. You know, all of a sudden eggs, the price of eggs seemed to go up. And I think the key is, what did you pay before? You know, so if you're aware of what you paid on a regular basis, you now know, you know, what that kind of leeway is to raise the price without it going way out of line for the price to be raised. And so right before I interrupted you, though, however, we talked about, you said something about bait and switch schemes. So how's that? What is that? Give us a little bit more. Give me an example of that.
Sure, absolutely. You know, and we're not endorsing any particular brand when we mention a brand name. It's just for an example purpose. We can't recommend a business or a store or a item to anyone. So, but when you're looking at an ad and it either in the paper or online, doesn't matter, or even at the store physically, and it says perhaps Johnson & Johnson brand sanitizer, and the price looks really good. It's $5.99 for a bottle, and you feel that's pretty fair. You go and you want to pick one up. You get there and they tell you they're out of Johnson & Johnson. But for the same price, they're going to give you Fred's homemade sanitizer. You don't know where Fred makes the sanitizer. You don't know what ingredients Fred's really putting in that sanitizer. And you don't think it's the same quality and value as the other named national brand. That's a bait and switch. You know, maybe they never had enough Johnson & Johnson in store to accommodate the sales ad, but it got you to come in the store. It's kind of like a lost lead. It gets people to walk into the store. And once you're in there, you're probably going to buy something, even though they don't have what you came for. So that's what bait and switch is. The store knows you're going to make more profit on Fred's brand than on the national brand, and they're advertising the national brand. Now, not all stores are doing that to be deceitful or fraudulent. Sometimes they just happen to run out, and they're going to offer you an alternate product. That's not bait and switch. That's a store that had good intentions. The stock was there, they ran the ad, and it sold out quickly. The bait and switch is when that store is doing it purposely and never had enough to begin with.
Okay, good. How about another one that you're finding, that another scam that's coming along also, whether it's part of this virus or just continuing as a regular scam?
Well, you know, we talk about investment scams, and, you know, everyone's trying to protect their finances, especially in the climate we're in right now. so many people are out of work. It's so sad. It's difficult times for families. We know there's stimulus checks and assistance coming, but it doesn't fix all your problems. You know, so folks are looking for any type of silver lining in this gray cloud. And all of a sudden, you're approached with this great opportunity. Here's an investment scam. It's going to save the day. Or will it ruin your life? I mean, if you don't do your homework and you don't know what you're getting into, you got to be careful. If money's tight, you have to be extra careful not to lose it to a fraud. So here's some tips to avoid the investment scams during the COVID-19 pandemic. Do your research. And we say that all the time, regardless of the pandemic, before you make an investment, do your research, do your homework. I keep saying that, but it's important. Contact the Pennsylvania Department of Banking and Securities or other financial resources to see what you can find out before putting any of your hard-earned money on the line. Watch out for the advice from these unsolicited sources. All of a sudden, you're getting emails and pop-ups and text messages and calls. You know, I'd go to a trusted source. I wouldn't take the word of an unknown person or investor. I'd want to talk to my financial institutions that I know and trust every day and start there. Some of these will offer you a research report, a white paper. They'll mail you something, email you something. Be sure you know if it's actually legitimate. They can be falsified, and they can put a spin on it and make it look like it's official. They'll even have the inclination to sometimes post Harvard University, Yale, any of these large investment firms, Charles Schwab. They'll use the name of it, pretty much anybody, to kind of validate it. Look out for the claims to cure COVID-19. We're offering vaccines or new medical breakthroughs. You know, again, you got to know if it's real. You got to do that homework. And again, I can't emphasize enough is going to a government agency for help. Banking and Securities Pennsylvania has a great agency. We work with them all the time. And, you know, our partnership between the Office of Attorney General and Banking and Securities is very solid. They do good work there, and they will certainly help guide you through this.
You know, I think that that investment scam is a good example of how the criminals, I'll call them, are taking advantage of the situation and really enhancing that. Because, you know, we have people that will do that on a regular basis throughout the year without the pandemic, as you said. But part of what the scammers do is utilize the situation. They want to get you. They want to tell you the urgency. You know, this is important because, you know, right now with the pandemic, you know, a lot of us who had investments have lost perhaps a lot of money. So, you know, we're all thinking we got to make that up. We want to, you know, we don't want to lose more money. And so the scammers know that. And they are saying, hey, you know, they're using the situation of the virus because we lost funds. But that's what they do throughout the year is the urgency. And, you know, the I'm going to guess that they say to the people, and you have to invest before, you know, tomorrow at, you know, or today at 5 p.m. Or, you know, they give a time frame, they give an urgency. So they utilize their usual tactics and then apply it with this because of the situation, right, Dave?
Absolutely. You know, I just read in Forbes that they claim there's over $800 million in estimated scams that have occurred during the COVID-19 pandemic. So that just gives you an idea of how at risk we all are. And again, you know, I always say this too at the end, but I'm going to throw it out right now. If you believe you've been a victim, do not be embarrassed or ashamed in any way. These people are ruthless and they're terrible fraudsters. Please step up and come forward. Let us know about it so we can help you and then we can educate others. Very important.
Yeah, thank you. One of the other things I think that the scammers are using at this time is as we started that we were all in this together and there's so many programs and groups of people who are trying to do things for others. And they are legitimate groups that have formed that are providing food for people or raising funds that could go to supply food or other services like that. But one of the things that disturbs me that you mentioned, and I want you to talk about it, is the charity scams.
Absolutely. You know, and it's nice to be able to help out when you can and do things for others. But again, is it a real charity? Is it a charity that you should be trusting with your hard-earned money or your valuable time? You know, we have agents that are out now, and some of our employees are helping at food drives, and we're helping with testing sites and other things in the community. It's all about community engagement and how we can all do our part. If you're healthy and you're available, we need you out there. But again, we don't want you to expose yourself unnecessarily. We don't want you to be engaged with a charity that you can't confirm to be valid. We don't want you to lose your hard-earned money. So never donate till you check them out. And watch out for the high pressure. These phone calls are terrible. The scammers know we're all captive audience. We're home. We have a stay-at-home order. We know that we're going to pick up the phone. We're lonely, and we're looking for communication and engagement with others. Yeah. Perfect storm for this scam. They'll call you and tell you how they're going to help people. They need your assistance to do so. Well, ask them for something. Ask for last year's financial report. Hey, can you mail me your financial report for that charity, how you've operated in the past? Look out for the copycats. They'll use those familiar names, Red Cross, United Way, Salvation Army, or they'll make up new names. You know, the COVID-19 charity fund. Is it real? I don't know. Without checking it out, how would you know?
Yeah.
So, you know, go online, do a search, put in the name of the charity, put in the word scam or fraud and see what comes up. Check with Pennsylvania Department of State, the Bureau of Charities there. They're great people. They'll start to help you determine how to reach the charity if it's even valid.
Great, thank you. Yep. One other thing that's come up during this time frame is the CARES Act, C-A-R-E-S. And now you're telling me, is there a CARES Act scam as well?
Well, yeah, they'll scam anything, Ann. You know, people are in need of that stimulus check. We want to protect our economy as best that we can and make people feel that they're in control of their personal lives and have the funds and resources they need. And that's what the CARES Act is all about. You know, they want to make sure that we're recovering economically as well as our health. So when people are contacting you, no one from a legitimate government office is going to call to verify your information. Not happening. No one should be on the phone telling you you have to provide social security number, date of birth, insurance numbers, or any type of personal or financial information. They'll pretend to be government offices, Small Business Association, the Internal Revenue Service, Centers for Disease Control, Food and Drug Administration, and it goes on and on. You know, just be careful. Watch out for these things. Same thing with the recovery grant. If you're in business or you're an employee of a business, you know, no one should be asking for that information directly by phone or email or text. You don't pay fees to receive your stimulus check or make it go through the process any quicker. No one should be calling you. And if you're not sure, you should contact the IRS.
Yep. Thank you. I know that we talked earlier and you had a great acronym for SCAM. Would you care to share that with us, Dave?
Yeah, you know, we're kind of proud of this at the Office of Attorney General. We sat down one day and I said to a colleague, I said, we have to come up with a way to break down the mechanics of how these scams operate. Because I always hear the same thing from folks. Oh, I've never heard that scam before. Or that's a new one on me. Boy, they're terrible. They're creative. They come up with these different types of scams. How do we keep track? How do we identify them? And I said, yeah. There's got to be an easier way. And this is what we did. We thought about it and we said, geez, most of these scams occur with sudden contact. You're not expecting to hear from this person or this organization. And they pressure you to act now. They want you to do things quickly. There's that sense of urgency. And then, of course, to fix whatever the problem is or to comply, you need money or your information, your personal data. So we broke it down to equal the word scam, S-C-A-M, sudden contact, act now, money or information usually is a scam. So that's a great way to look at it. And they're all emotional triggers. When we're fearful, when we're joyful, when we're looking after loved ones and we have that family need, those are the things that they exploit. They look for that emotional trigger. You know, even with the regular scams, it's the same thing. Right now we're talking about COVID. Someone might call you and say, there's someone in your neighborhood and we can't tell you who that's been infected. Now, to help you with that, we have an app that you can put on your phone to keep yourself away from people and be safe. You go to the link to download the app and it's spyware. They've invaded your contacts and taken over your computer. So, you know, these are the kind of things that we're warning about.
Okay. Well, we have only a couple minutes left, Dave. So could you give us some last minute quick consumer tips, and then we'll go right into your resources, okay?
Absolutely. Know who you're dealing with. Big tip. Never provide personal or financial information to unknown callers or email contacts. Avoid claims of cures and vaccines. There's no magic pill. Watch your emails for those tags at the end. Is it cdc.com? Is it cdc.org? No, the Centers for Disease Control are cdc.gov, the irs.gov. Most government offices are .gov or .us, you know, so watch for that and obtain information from trusted sources. The Centers for Disease Control, your local and state government, your healthcare providers, that's where we want you to be going for your information.
And our resources for us if we need to get a hold of somebody to report this scam or we think we're scammed.
Right away, contact the Office of the Attorney General, our Bureau of Consumer Protection for consumer-related complaints, including the healthcare complaints, at 1-800-441-2555. Also, our Senior Protection Helpline is available for any concern or question for Pennsylvanians over the age of 60 or their family members and caregivers. Call Senior Protection at 1-866-623-2137. You can email any type of scam attempt electronically to scams@attorneygeneral.gov. And you may report price gouging as well at any of these extensions, including the email pricegouging@attorneygeneral.gov.
And the website is www.attorneygeneral.gov. And what I'd like to say is also, if anybody has any other questions or concerns, we're certainly here also to be able to help and to provide this information. They can contact the Berks County Area Agency on Aging at 610-478-6500. So we're out of time, Dave. You provided wonderful information for us all to be out there and aware that the scam artists are continuing and to not be fooled by them and remember scam. So thanks again so much for your time, Dave, and your wonderful information, and appreciate you being my guest on our Aging Matters show today. Thanks.
Thank you, Ann. Take care and stay healthy. Thank you.
Thanks. You too.
You guys able to keep up with the slides?
Aging Matters on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Area Agency on Aging.